with February around the corner, let me show you how I plan my projects out for the year, and I promise it won't take long at all. First things first, I list out all of the things that I want to get done this year. Obviously, makes sense, right? So I imagine it's December 2021. What do I want to have accomplished? And this is really important if you have big goals, like I'm planning on finishing a book this year and launching my podcast. So anything that's complex like that, a multi-month project, let's say, you're gonna wanna write it down and really be clear about what it is that you wanna have at the end of December, at the end of the year. Then I like to calculate how many days I'll actually have to work on these projects. Now, don't skip the step, okay? It sounds simple, but it's really not. So I plan things on a quarterly cycle, and you might say, okay, Rahaf, like a quarter is 90 days, we get it. But not so fast, because from those 90 days, if you take out weekends, birthdays, social obligations, holidays, conferences, vacations, sick days, days when you have migraines, you'll realize that maybe instead of 90 days, you'll have something like 55 days. And knowing this should help you figure out how to spread your task. So for example, I know I can write between 1,500 and 2,000 words every day. And I know that by the end of the month, I need 15,000 words. So that means I need to allocate at least 10 days in order for me to hit my word count, which now leaves me with 45 days to do the rest of my projects. So I just go over all of the different projects and I make sure that I have enough time allocated for them. A book might take me 170 days out of the year. I need to make sure I have those days. Then I take a simple grid system so I can get an overview of the year quarter by quarter because I do these 90-day sprints. And I start to schedule in these milestones. So if I want to have my book done by the end of the year, that might mean I need a rough draft done by July or an outline done by the end of February. So just to get a sense of how my deadlines are going to play out. Because it's one thing if you have one project, but once you have multiple projects, you want to make sure that you're not overloading a particular month. So once I do that, I split my page and I figure out, okay, what do I need to do quarter by quarter? So what do I need to do for the next quarter, the next 55 days to make sure that I'm going to get it all done? So for example, for next month, I have to write 15,000 words. And the month after that, I need to write another 15,000 words. And I just need to make sure that I'm allocating the time to do that. So I do this every single quarter and I adjust and adapt as needed. So it doesn't really take me a lot of time to do this planning. And it shouldn't, because you shouldn't actually overplan, because you'll have to compensate for unexpected delays. At the end of every quarter, I sit and review, and just to make sure that everything still makes sense. So now, every month, I make a master list of everything I need to do, including personal stuff, errands, house stuff, whatever. Just get it out of my head and onto the page in no particular order. If there are any projects, I break them down into their subtasks so there's no ambiguity. Then I make my monthly overview that breaks down the month into its 4 weeks. And this is when I start going through my monthly list, I prioritize, and I figure out exactly when I'm going to do each of these tasks. I look at my projects, look at my obligations, and then every Sunday, I sit down with my weekly spread, which is just one page with 5 rows, one for each day of the week, and I start slotting in tasks based on when it makes the most sense. There is a method to my madness, though. I always put my most important project first. So for me, it's writing. I always make sure I get that word count scheduled first. And this makes sure that my urgent projects don't overtake the stuff that's important but not urgent, right? So my inbox won't completely derail me. I always remember what I want to focus on and what the most important thing is going to be by the time I get to December. Second, because I'm a hustle and floater, I schedule personal time, downtime, workouts, meal preps, things that make sure that I'm taking care of myself, because that's just as important for me to have my best performance ever. And this system really works for me. It's not that hard, right? Like, it lets me adapt and adjust to my weeks, to travel pre-pandemic, and it lets me make sure that I'm working on the things that matter. Finally, a little trick is I leave my Fridays pretty open, just as a catch-all, as a buffer day in case I didn't quite get to everything that I wanted to the rest of the week. So that's it. Sunday, review your week. Every month, review your task list. And every quarter, just review the days that you have, make the calculations, and then plan accordingly. It's really simple. It does not take a lot of time. It gives me incredible peace of mind. And it's the one system that I've gone back to over and over and over again. So I hope this helps, and happy planning.